Hi, I'm Tim Berglund with Confluent. You know, I don't think change data capture gets enough respect. Why not? Well, let's think back to when it started and let's ask for a little help from a 3D printer. In the early days of relational databases, things like real-time backups and replication were not easy. A backup was typically a batch process that involved dumping a big file from a database and then moving it to another server, cloning it, if you will. Change data capture entered the world as a means of capturing database mutations as they occurred and shipping them to another database that was more or less a perfect copy of the first one. Anytime there was an update, an insert, or a delete, the CDC process captured it. This kept your backup fresh as changes occurred, which batch backups just couldn't do. CDC solved several critical problems. For one, it gave us real-time replication, enabling live, active, passive database configurations. It made migrations easier for when you needed to move a database to a new data center or a different version of the same database, or maybe to some new database platform altogether. And of course, disaster recovery, which was a hot topic in the early 2000s, was a disaster without it. And this was all really cool at the time. But like the first couple of seasons of the Clone Wars, CDC can feel a little dated these days. But like Captain Rex, whose helmet we're printing right now, it refused to die. It lived on as a workhorse piece of the enterprise data stack, quietly replicating relational databases like it was supposed to. But it went from hot new enabling technology to kind of just a normal part of life. Then Kafka happened. You see, in the world of data streaming, CDC is a bedrock technology. The fact is, we still have enterprises full of relational databases, and I defy you to envision a time when we're not going to. Those databases are highly interconnected to the new parts of the enterprise that are built on streaming, the systems built on Kafka. CDC is what makes that happen. With CDC in your toolbox, you can keep building streaming data pipelines and modern event-driven applications while still having access to whatever's going on in the legacy source systems, which are typically powered by relational databases. You get a continuous, low-latency stream of database changes, inserts, updates, deletes, available in a Kafka topic, ready for you to process and consume in whatever way you need. And having that record of database changes stored in an immutable log gives you access to functionality that would take a lot of extra work in most databases, like auditing or replaying history. And the log gives you some decoupling as well. Without data streaming or CDC, you'd probably write a downstream app that just queries the database directly, and I might add, synchronously, which means that that app's uptime is 100% dependent on the database's uptime. Now, any downstream systems are decoupled from the source, which is always a win. This is a scalability win as well. Now think about it. You only impose a load on the database once by reading out the changes, and in many cases, this is cheaper than a normal database read. And once they're in the highly scalable distributed log that is Kafka, the number of readers can fan out quite a bit without the database ever knowing a thing. And if you're using Confluent Cloud, you can apply governance to deal with future schema changes. You know they'll happen. And use stream processing tools like Apache Flink to perform real-time computation on that stream of changes as well. This moves you towards the holy grail of reusable data products, which is a place we all desperately want to land. CDC was cool once, then it was boring. Now it's essential. If you're a data streaming engineer, this is a tool in your toolbox. Confluent has CDC connectors for the most popular systems: Postgres, MySQL, Oracle, SQL Server, DynamoDB, MongoDB, even Salesforce. You can use these on Confluent Cloud alongside 80 or so other fully managed connectors for other kinds of systems and tasks. If you want to sign up on Confluent Cloud, check the link and the discount code in the description, and you can get started capturing and streaming change data for free. You can also subscribe to this channel if you'd like, or not. The right videos are probably going to find you either way.